Happy Monday morning, everybody, and thank you for turning on the radio here on WCLU. It's the time of day where we hopefully get your day started off right and your week started off right as well by reviewing some of the pathway that got us here. It's called the Archive. Sam Terry. What is your last name? Sam Terry. I don't know where I was going with that. But anyway, Mr. W. Samuel Terry IV is here, and well-known historian, well-respected writer, author, all those things. But I'm just glad to sit in the studio with you here on a daily basis and talk about history, sir. Is that okay?
Always a fun thing to do.
I've got some history from 19 and 24 that was published this day in the Glasgow Times. It's about Miss Catherine Banks. She is the daughter of Dr. and Mrs. William Hamlin Banks of Mifflintown, Pennsylvania, and she was married to John Evans Richardson, the son of Judge and Mrs. Basil Richardson of Glasgow, at the Westminster Presbyterian Church in Mifflintown, Pennsylvania. What about that?
100 years ago.
That's a pretty good ways to go for a wedding, and certainly, I'm sure, a nice couple indeed back in 1924.
Indeed. And of course, we have Mr. Richardson's name brought up frequently. He's the namesake of Richardson Field at Gorham Park, and was highly involved in the community, and their son was rather famous as a makeup artist to the stars in Hollywood and New York City for several years.
It's wonderful where you can go from here, isn't it?
It is.
And we like to share that on the archives. Now, I like the headline here in 1934's article in the Glasgow Republican, Sam, "Motored from California." I'm going to read that story, aren't you?
Of course.
Mr. and Mrs. Bob Taylor arrived Sunday by car from Woodlake, California, and are visiting friends and relatives here. This is the second trip by motor to Kentucky in recent years. 8 days were used on this trip, with Mr. Taylor doing all of the driving. A previous trip required only 5 days, when four people alternated as drivers. This is 1934.
Wow.
How confident are you that from here to California, there's enough service stations and parts houses to get you there? I'm saying it was a pretty scary trip.
It was an endurance test.
They made it twice, at least.
Of course, no air conditioning in automobiles in 1934.
Yeah. So roll those windows down.
Kind of a hot ride, too.
1944, the Glasgow Times has reported that employees of the Kentucky Pants Factory purchased a total of $10,933.85 in the Fifth War Loan Bond Drive. Most of them make regular monthly payments on the bonds, but they add to in each drive. So you think about, can you imagine how unpopular that would be today if we were in a war and we were borrowing money from our citizens to fight the war?
Exactly.
Yet people were giving without complaint and actually raising what they were giving each one of these war loan bond drives. This one was the fifth one here in 1944, Sam.
It took everyone.
1954, we got an article in the Glasgow Times and Evening Journal. And the headline here, I want to read the rest of this story. Welding tank blows up at a garage here. A welding tank blew up this morning about 8 o'clock at the Elmore Garage back of the service station at 202 South Broadway. Nobody was injured. The Glasgow Fire Department sped to the scene and brought the fire under control. No major damage was reported. But anytime a welding tank blows up, I'm getting out of there.
Yes. Kind of scary way to begin the morning.
Exactly right. It doesn't do so quietly, does it? Here we go in the 1964 Glasgow Daily Times. A regular series in the Glasgow Times was Little League Behind the Plate, a series written by the one and only Bill Luster. We knew he was a famous photographer, but he's got some good writing credits, too, doesn't he, Sam?
Well, he certainly does.
And what a wonderful photographer. Just a fun guy to talk to as well.
One of our legendary locals.
No question. 1974, the Times reports that Larry Morrison won the 1974 Vega at the Barren County Fair. Drawing for the new car was the concluding event of the fair. Now, that's a big promotion there in 1974 to get people to come to the fair. Hey, we'll give away a car. And they gave away the big 74 Vega. Wasn't that the one with like an aluminum engine or something in it? It seemed like I remember.
Yeah, there were some unique things about the Vega, as
that's
I
right.
recall.
It was this day in 1984 where we learned in the Times that Kentucky Adjutant General Willman has announced the promotion of John L. Smith to the rank of Brigadier General in the Air National Guard. Congratulations to John Smith for that accolade there in 1984. 1994, we learned in the Times, the new Temple Hill Volunteer Fire Department's Roseville substation is now officially open. We can't brag on our volunteer fire departments enough. And to have that Roseville station open out there at the Temple Hill Volunteer Fire Department makes it faster and gives them more range and certainly makes everybody sleep a little better at night, too. You know what I'm saying?
Certainly does. And how we appreciate all of our volunteer firemen.
We really do. 2004, the Barren County Progress reports that work is underway on the second phase of the Glasgow Outer Loop from Highway 90 to U.S. 6880. That was certainly a big undertaking back in 2004. Had to get that outer loop finished, and phase two was underway. They got that part of it done pretty quickly, you know, and we are benefiting from it today. And then we have this day in 2014... in the Barren County Progress, Paul Bewley was named the Student of the Year at the annual GED graduation ceremony. Congratulations to Mr. Bewley. What do you think? Is that enough for Monday?
I think so.
That's 100 years worth of things, and there's no slouchy story in there. They're all really good. Big, what do they call it now? Breaking news. Breaking news. We have breaking news from 100 years, and we'll come back tomorrow, Sam.
I'll see you then.
And see if we can't come up with some more neat things that have put our history into motion here on the archives.